the Holy Ghost. God is looking up here for believers. And there is a process to becoming a true believer.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? Abraham's testimony didn't get in the Bible by happenstance. He had to endure something for us to know his story. And God says, I want you to look at Abraham. See, there's going to come to the point where you cross over into this place. You're going to have to come to the point where you believe against hope. Anybody in here has been promised God, something by God that you can't see that's going to happen.
Amen.
That's just me. Amen. I have a promise over my life in the garden. I know there's nothing I can do to bring it to pass. But you know the way I see that this morning? I see it as a setup. I see that as a setup that I'm blessed to know Abraham. Because when God showed me that Abraham had no more confidence in himself, no more confidence in Sarah, he had no more confidence in nobody in the heaven. The only thing he had, while you shout about him, was a promise. The only thing that he had to move forward on was a promise. Does anybody need to have a promise from God that you truly receive? Because if you don't walk in the promise, it's going to come to the place where you say, I know it ain't working. I'm not going to give up. How many of you have to tell that devil every day, I am not giving up. I don't care what you do. I am not giving up. I'm going to church tomorrow, devil. I'm going to pray anyhow. Oh, I'm not giving up. I wish I had two people who understood what I was talking about. How often do you tell me that? I don't care what you do. I don't care who you use. I am not giving up. I'm gonna still keep worshiping. I'm gonna still keep loving. I'm not giving up. I don't care how it goes. Let me close this. If you want to have a strong a weapon in your arsenal, get this whip into your spirit. I will not give up. You hear this again? Listen, if you want the strongest weapons of your arsenal that you have in words, is, I am not going to give up. Sometimes that thing would break a spiritual attack in your life. Just when the devil think he got to the point of calling up someone and saying, you know, I ain't going to church no more. I'm tired of this relationship. I want a divorce. I want to get out of here. I ain't giving these children no more. I don't want to be on this job no more. But just when you get to the point, you have to learn the devil and I, I'm not going to give up on what God told me. I'm not going to give up on what God gave me. I don't care how it looks the only pain I'm under. I'm not going to give up because I'm fully dependent. So whatsoever he promised, he's also able to perform it. Somebody give God a shout praise. You got to hold on, baby. You too close to where you're going. This ain't the time talking to somebody. This is not the time to give in. The devil's alive. This is not the time to become a spiritual power. Stand up in the midst of your trouble. Stand up in the midst of your pain. Stand up in the midst of frustration. And say, I am blessed with every spiritual blessing. God's going to get some glory out of this situation. Shut up, stand up and be counted. Be bold, make declaration. I am a millionaire. God said it. I believe it. I not get it now, but somebody, well, I'm victorious. Somebody open him up and say, I am victorious. I am more than a conqueror. I am blessed. Glory to God. God, don't get some glory out of this. Sit down and be glorious. I feel like prophesying here. Listen, this month just switched over. We 5 days into the second half. You ought to have an expectancy. You shouldn't even allow the devil place in your mind right now. Your mind should be so consumed with what God's going to do next. Your vision to be a wonderful door. He's going to open next. I know money is coming. I wonder how it's coming. I know breakthrough is coming. I wonder how it's coming. You should be pregnant with what's going to happen next. Take your eyes off of yourself. Who feeling sorry for yourself? That's a trick of the devil. Oh, woe is me. The whole world against me. I can't believe a pastor talked to me like that. Oh, my boss crazy. This whole company crazy. My mama done lost her mind. Feeling sorry for yourself. And you're right in the devil's camp. I don't know why nothing ever works for me because you didn't expect it to work. Expectation. You don't have no baby, don't expect them when they come. When you get it pregnant, you get expectation. That's 9 months down the road. You start buying this and buying that and eating this, eating that. Everything changes because you're expecting something. I feel like we should. Let me ask you something. What in your life has changed since you got the promise that God gave you access? What have you done to adjust to make sure that when it comes, you receive it. Who did you listen to God say that given to some of the people? Who did you tell? God help me, so that you can be ready for what's coming. Ain't nobody can say amen.